Morning guys, Suzie here, hope everybody's okay. Thought we'd make pancakes this morning for breakfast. So, here we go, we've got the ingredients here. So we have got some oil for the frying pan. We've got some milk, you can use any kind of milk, whether it's blue, green or red. We've got some sugar, again, any kind of sugar, granulated, caster, whatever you've got handy. Some self-raising flour and some eggs. And I've already weighed my milk out here. So let's go. Nice and easy. We're just going to make a small amount so you can double it up as you want. But we always start with 100 grams of self-raising flour. And to 100 grams of self-raising flour, we'll zero that. And we're going to add 50 grams of sugar. Okay. There we go. And to the 50 grams of sugar, we're going to add one egg. And we're going to add 100 mils of cold milk. Going to get the whisk and we're going to whisk it together. We don't want any lumps in it. So make sure when you pour your milk in, you pour all your milk in at one time. Okay. And we'll whisk that together until we've got no lumps. There we go, quick as that. Okay, so on my cooker, I've got a frying pan and it's been sitting on a low heat for a little while just to warm it up. So I'm going to turn it up very slightly and I'm going to use the oil. And now I've got a spray oil and I'm just going to put maybe four sprays in. If you don't have spray oil, you can use some regular oil. Let me just get some kitchen roll. So what you could do is just pour a little bit of oil, maybe about a teaspoon, and use your cloth, use a piece of paper towel very carefully because it's going to be hot, and wipe it around your pan. You could maybe ask mum, dad, or one of your carers to help you with that. Okay, so I've got a spoon ready, and I've also got a spatula, and that's going to help to flip them over when they're ready. So we'll take some of the batter. We're going to judge how many we're going to fit in the pan. I think I'll maybe put three in this pan. There you go. And you do them whatever size you'd like them. You can have them bigger or smaller. Okay. There we go. So there's three in the pan. And now we have to be patient. I'm going to wait until the bubbles start rising on the top of the pancakes before we flip them over. Okay guys, so I've waited a couple of minutes and the bubbles are starting to appear on the top of the pancake. So now I'm going to use my spatula. Here we go, and I'm going to flip them over very carefully. Let's try this one first. There we go. Oh. Okay. And this one. Oh, how good do they look? There we go. And again, we're going to leave them for another couple of minutes to cook on the other side. Okay guys, so that's the pancakes all made. As you can see, I managed to get six out of that batch altogether, so that lets you know how many you can make. So if you've got a bigger family, or you want to save some for the next day, then you could always make some more. If it's just yourself, then that's probably a good amount to make, and that will last you a couple of days. Just wrap them up tightly with some cling film or in a freezer bag. So let's take them over and we're going to have them this morning for breakfast. I've got my coffee ready. Here we go. So I'm going to have one today with, I'm going to have some yogurt. Now you could have bacon, you could have jam, you could have, what else could you have? Some syrup. I'm going to have some yogurt. I'm going to put some bananas on top, have these ready sliced. I'll have a drizzle of some nice healthy honey. There we go. drizzle that over the top. And I think just to finish it off, now no double dipping with your spoons, remember. So I'll put that there and that'll be ready for the next one. And I'm going to finish mine off today with a little sprinkle of cinnamon. There we go. So there we go, guys. Cheers, have a good day, and let us know what you've been up to. Bye.